So, Douglas, now the unavoidable question, AI. Do you think it's gonna destroy jobs, create new ones? It's gonna kill us all? What do you think is gonna happen in the near future?
I guess the safest answer would be all of the above. But I don't know. I definitely have concerns about it. I'm annoyed at the recklessness of the companies that are driving this, that they've got into this spiral where the, anybody who thinks they can make a buck on AI is now pushing it hard. And the way it came about, I have serious doubts about the roots of the current stuff. The work that started back in the 50s, they were trying to figure out how do we represent knowledge and understanding and meaning, and how do we apply logic to that to solve problems. And that totally failed because they couldn't solve the common sense problem. Common sense is the basis of all of our reasoning, and we don't know how we do it well enough to teach a computer how to do it. So now we have AI systems that are divorced of common sense, of meaning and understanding and knowledge. Well, they have the knowledge, or at least the pattern of the knowledge, but they don't understand what it means. And as a result, we're going to tend to overestimate what it's capable of. But the problem with the current model is when it's presented with something it's never seen before, it has no basis for doing a correct thing. But it also has no awareness that it is doing a wrong thing. And I would like to see the commercialization of all this new AI halted until that problem is solved. If an AI can reasonably say, I don't know what to do in this situation, I would have a lot more confidence. But they don't. And so, like, if we have AIs flying planes, I'm really concerned that they're going to get in a situation they've never encountered before, and planes will fall out of the sky again. Or self-driving cars, there's a similar issue there. If I'm considering buying an experimental car. It doesn't look like any car you've ever seen. And I'm guessing that Tesla's AIs have never seen it either. So when they see my car on the road,
my sweet cow, then
who knows what they're gonna do? If they start hallucinating the way the other systems do, that could be bad.
What car is that?
Aptera. It's a solar-powered, high-efficiency car. They're building parts of it in Italy. Mm-hmm. It's amazing, and they might go into production next year.
Cool.
So I'm not worried just for myself. It's also, there are situations where you might see a kid who puts a cardboard box over himself pretending to be a robot. The AI has never seen that before. It doesn't recognize it as a human and takes the wrong action. So AI doesn't know what it doesn't know, and I would like it to not go any further until we solve that problem.
Yeah, that would be the wisest thing to do, but there's kind of an arms race between the companies that might prevent that. So we just did the graduation of some of our students. That's why you're wearing this weird outfit. And these guys are just starting in our market. And they're starting at maybe a bit of a complicated time with all these tools like LLMs and Copilot. What would be your recommendation for these people? What would you do if you were in their shoes?
I would say be like me, except there's nobody like me, and I don't think anyone will ever be like me again. So my career has been magical and weird, and I don't think that's a way forward for anybody else. Just generally be as knowledgeable as you can, and in particular, understand the foundations. Because you know, at the stuff is changing all the time. There are fads and breakthroughs and regressions and all that, but the fundamentals never change.
Never change.
They get added to slowly, but they don't ever get invalidated. So, unfortunately, it's hard to say learn the fundamentals and that turns into income. Mm-hmm. But if you're looking for a long career, that's the place you have to go.
That's the exact same recommendation. There's the stuff that will get you a job tomorrow. There's the stuff that will keep you in this market for 20, 30 years. And you need to concentrate on those. You need the first two. But you need the fundamentals and you need to get them right. So I think that's excellent advice. What do you think that makes Keep Coding different in the bootcamp market from what you've seen? I know that you don't have a deep understanding of our operation, but you have at least some idea. So if there's anything that you think that stands out.
So I know even less about your competitors.
Okay.
So I can't give you a comparison there because I literally don't know. From what I've seen of your operation, I have a lot of respect for you and all of your people.
Thank you.
And I've really enjoyed the two shows I've been allowed to participate in. And if that's an indication of the quality that you're doing, then it looks pretty good to me.
We most certainly hope to see you on the third, which would be actually our fourth Connect. So unless there is another pandemic or we start a war against AI or anything like that, we'll be here again. Douglas, thank you very much. It's really an honor to have you here back, and we'll make sure that we can transmit your knowledge to all our students. We'll have AI translate all this stuff for them. So thank you very much, and then hopefully see you next year. Bye-bye.